Hey everyone, Sandeep here from 99signals.com. Today I want to talk about Facebook marketing, or to be more specific, I want to talk about a Facebook marketing tool that not a lot of people are aware of. This is a free tool, but despite it being free, you can gain a ton of insights on your competitors and Facebook advertising in general. Now tell me if this has happened with you. You are on Facebook and suddenly you see an ad that really connects with you on an emotional level. Now if you're a marketer like me, you would be more curious to know what this company is doing, how they're running all their ads, and how their whole Facebook marketing engine works. So today this happened with me. I stumbled upon a Red Bull ad. It was a 6-second animation ad. And I wanted to know more about what Red Bull is doing on Facebook. Red Bull, as you know, is known for their marketing and advertising especially online marketing. They have a robust presence. They have close to 50 million fans on Facebook, and I really wanted to learn more about what they're doing on Facebook and what kind of different ads that they're running. And using this tool, I was able to see a lot of ads that they're running, not just in my country, but in other countries as well. Now, the tool that I'm using is called Facebook Ad Library, and it's a tool by Facebook. It's a free tool. You don't need to pay a monthly subscription for this. But using this tool, you can gain a ton of insights on your competitors or any business in general that is really killing it on Facebook. Now, if you've not had a great experience using Facebook ads, if you have not seen any results, or you would just like to learn more about Facebook ads, then you can really use this tool and get a ton of insights from it. You can see how your competitors are doing. Maybe you have a competitor in your niche who's really using Facebook ads effectively to reach out to their target audience, and they're doing a pretty good job at it. You can see exactly what they're doing, the kind of ads that they're running, the kind of copy that they use, and the landing pages that they use. So it need not be your competitor. It can be any business. Like in this case, I'm talking about Red Bull. It can be any business which has a good Facebook marketing strategy. Now, if you see a page that is posting content on a regular basis, chances are that they're leveraging Facebook ads as well. You can go to their page and see the kind of ads that they're running. Now, in this video, I'll show you exactly how you can start using Facebook Ad Library and the three main insights that you can gain by using this tool. So let's begin. To access Facebook Ad Library, just go to the page that you would like to research on and look for something called Page Transparency on the right side. Once you find that section, click on the See More link and it'll open a new pop-up window, and you need to look for a section called Ads from this page. Once you find that, click on Go to Ad Library, and it'll open Ad Library for you, and it'll show you all the active and inactive ads of that page in your location. So in this case, I've chosen HubSpot because in the B2B space, they have really mastered the art of Facebook marketing. They run a lot of Facebook ads, but unfortunately in my country, they're not running any ads at the moment. Maybe India is not a very critical market for them. You'll also see some information under page transparency. You'll see the number of admins that they have in each locations, wherever they have their presence. And since HubSpot is a Boston-based company, understandably, most of the admins are in the United States. And one can determine that most of their ads are also in the US. So let's select United States as the location here. Let me filter by United States. And now I'll be seeing all the active and inactive ads in the US. And by default, it will show you both active and inactive ads. You can just select active ads to see the ads that are currently live. And with all these ads, you'll be seeing the start date as well. This is the date when they started running their ads. In the case of HubSpot, many of their ads are video ads. As you may already know, videos get a lot more engagement than images on Facebook these days. And maybe that's the reason they've gone with videos for their ads. And most of the ads are simply sponsored posts. That means someone has posted something on their page and they're just boosting it to reach a wider audience and get more engagement. Aside from this one ad where they are promoting their free marketing software, everything else is informative content or educational content that they're boosting. So it's meant for their target audience. They have their buyer persona in mind when they're creating these ads. And some of them are case studies, some of them are concepts that they're trying to explain, and most of them are targeted towards small business owners and marketing agencies. So, like I said, in the B2B space, HubSpot has really mastered the art of Facebook marketing, and that's one of the reasons why I selected HubSpot this example. But you can go to any competitor or any business that you admire, any brand that is killing it in your niche when it comes to Facebook ads. You can go to their page and get some inspiration on how to run your ads. But aside from seeing all these ads, there are three insights that you can gain. One is the different copywriting formulas that these businesses are using. So copywriting plays a critical role when it comes to getting conversions on your ads, getting people to notice your ads. So look at their captions, look at the headlines that they're using, look at the description, see if they're using any power words. Power words are words that trigger an emotional response. They get us to click on ads. So see if they're using any power words. In HubSpot's case, they're using words like free, unlimited. These are words that really create an emotional impact and they pack a punch. So look at your competitor, see if they're using similar words in their creative or Facebook captions. When it comes to CTA buttons, HubSpot is currently not using any since most of their ads are sponsored posts. But if you go to a page like Shopify, you'll see them using CTA. So Learn More is the most popular CTA. You can also use Shop Now, Book Now, whichever creative makes sense for your niche, for your business. So copywriting is the first thing that I would like you to see. If you have never run Facebook ads before, or if you're struggling to get conversions on your Facebook ads, just look at the different copywriting formulas that are being used by your competitors or businesses that you really admire, because chances are that they would have arrived at their captions by doing a lot of A-B testing. They would have used a lot of headline variations, and only then they would have arrived at something that is really getting them maximum conversions. So that's the first thing. Second thing is look at the ad creative or the Facebook ad type that they're using. In HubSpot's case, like I said, many of their ads are video ads, and the kind of ads that they're running, most of them are very short videos, 30-second to 50-second videos, where they're trying to explain a concept or where they are trying to explain how a particular company goes about their marketing. They're very educational, they're very informative, and in some cases, they're very entertaining. Very few of their ads are sales-oriented. Now, let's look at a different page. Let's look at a page like Shopify. And in Shopify's case, their target audience are small business owners or aspiring entrepreneurs who are looking to open their own online store. But sometimes by looking at the creative itself, you can figure out the demographic that the company is targeting. And like I said, in Shopify's case, they are targeting aspiring entrepreneurs and business owners. So in Shopify's case, they have a lot of content marketing assets. They have a lot of blog posts they are trying to convert. And as such, most of their ads are basically blog posts that are being boosted. So that's what I noticed with Shopify. The third thing you can learn from Facebook ad library is obviously the landing pages that they're using. So let's click on this HubSpot ad. And HubSpot is known for their landing pages. They tend to optimize their landing pages, and they are very conversion friendly. So in this case, this is an optimized landing page. They are promoting their marketing software here. And once again, check out the kind of content they're using, check out the copy that they have, and you can probably emulate the same thing, or you can probably create a similar one for your company, depending on who you're researching on. It may be your competitor who's really good at Facebook ads, or it may be someone entirely different, someone who's really mastered the craft of Facebook advertising. You can go to their page, see what they're doing, and see the kind of landing pages that they have. In Shopify's case, like I said, most of their landing pages are blog posts. They are promoting their blog posts, and most of their recent ads are articles which are targeted towards aspiring entrepreneurs. So these are the three insights you can gain from Facebook ad library. One is the different copywriting formulas that your competitor is using. You get to see the different captions, headline variations, CTAs that they're using, and what's working for them. Second is the Facebook ad type or the ad creative. Chances are they would have done a lot of A-B testing, and they would have seen results for all the active ads on their page. So you can probably do the same for your business. Third insight you can gain LinkedIn is landing pages. You can look at their landing pages and see if you can create an optimized one like them. In HubSpot's case, I see this ad quite often. I've been seeing it for weeks. That means it's working. The landing page that they've created for this ad is working, and it's helping them get leads and conversions. So these are the three insights you can gain. It's a very useful tool. It's a valuable tool for any marketer who would like to do competitor research. And the best part is it's a free tool. You don't have to invest anything in this tool. There's no monthly subscription. It's a free tool by Facebook. All you need to do is invest some time, and it can give you a lot of insights. You get to see what your competitors are doing on Facebook. You get to see how certain businesses are using Facebook ads to generate traffic for their website and get leads for their business. So start using this tool. I hope you found this tutorial useful. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section. I would be happy to answer them. And start using this. You can also go to this URL directly. You need not go to Facebook. You can just go to this URL and you can type in the name of the page that you would like to research on. So that's it. Get started with this tool and let me know the kind of insights you've been able to get on your competitors. And I hope by using this tool, you also get a fair idea as to how you can gain traction from Facebook advertising. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll be back very soon.